Okay, Thomas, go ahead. What's your math question?
My math question is 0 and 91 hundredths.
Okay.
Divided by 7.
0.91. I'm glad you read it that way. Good for you, Thomas. You read it as a regular number here. You said 0 and 91 hundredths. Quite often we refer to the decimal point by using the word and. It had two digits after the decimal point to the right of it, and that took you to the hundredths place, so you said 91 hundredths. All right, and we're dividing it by 7. Nice job presenting that problem, Thomas. Now, how would you start this?
Well, I would start it by using the division math box.
Okay, you're going to put a, yeah, I got the 0.91 in the box. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Okay, so we got the 0.91 inside it. We got our divisor, the 7, outside the box.
Yes.
Up in the answer area, where should we put the decimal point, Thomas?
We should put the decimal point in between the 0 and
then between the 0 and what?
And 91.
Okay, very good. So actually what I'm going to do is I'm going to line up the decimal point. Hey, Thomas, will 7 go into 0?
No.
Oh, so I'm going to put a 0 up here in my quotient. All right. Now we can say, will 7 go into 1? How many times, into 9. How many times will 7 go into 9, Thomas?
One time.
That's right. I was jumping to the answer, wasn't I? 1 times 7 is 7.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now what do we do, Thomas?
We do 9, take away 7.
All right, we're going to subtract. 9 take away 7 is 2, correct?
Yes.
And now what do?
We bring down the 1.
Very good. I'm going to show that. We're going to bring down this 1. And now we're going to figure out how many times 7 will go into 21, right?
It will go in, 7 will go into 21 three times.
Very good. How much of a remainder will we have?
0.
Yeah, this one worked out kind of nice. Now, if we had to go further, we could have added zeros, couldn't we, Thomas?
Yes.
All right, now, your teacher probably would like you to make sure this answer works. Do you know how to check this?
I'm not quite sure yet.
Okay, well, a lot of times, quite often, when we're checking these computations, we do the opposite of what we did to accomplish it. Well, this was a division problem. Thomas, what's the opposite of division?
Multiplication.
All right, so we would check by taking our answer and multiplying it by the divisor, which was 7. Help me out here, Thomas. What's 7 times 3?
7 times 3 is 21.
Right, we'll put down the 1, carry our 2. Thomas, what's 7 times 1?
7 times 1 is 7.
Okay, and 7 plus 2 is?
9.
Okay, very good. Of course, we could put 7 times 0 and put a 0 in there. We look at how many decimal points we have here. We got just the 1, and there's 2 digits to the right of it, so we'll go over 2 here, 0.91 here, 0.91 there. It checked, didn't it, Thomas?
Thank you.
Thank you. Nice call. Bye-bye.